JRay501. I'm in climate change, the next generation. And I'm going through some of these articles, and I thought this one was a little interesting. There are some very good studies, information on studies that are being done in the Arctic region, Alaska, Canada. This one: will fossil fuel companies face liability for climate change and their disinformation campaign? By Christine Shearer. In a recent article in the National Journal, Americans for Prosperity, AFP President Tim Phillips said there is no question that AFP and others like it have been instrumental in the rise of Republican candidates who question or deny climate science. AFP is a Section 501c4 organization, meaning it does not have to disclose its donors, but has been tied to significant funding from the Koch family foundations, founded by the billionaire monster Koch brothers of Koch Industries, as well as smaller donations from companies like ExxonMobil. Koch Industries and ExxonMobil are among the largest funders of studies questioning climate change science, often drawn upon by conservative politicians to legitimize their view that regulation of greenhouse gases is not needed because the science is still under debate. Okay, let me just stop there for just 1 minute, because I did want to take a look at the Koch family foundations for some of those that really don't know how monstrous they are. Koch Industries is one of the richest privately held corporations in the world, and they are two of the 20 wealthiest people in the world. They have bought their way into complete and utter destruction with total disregard to any regulations for pollution or anything. They just don't care, because they're a slave to money. They bow. They edify the dollar, or in their world it would be $1 billion. So here's a list of the organizations that are funded. Below is a list of the present and past recipients of funding from one or more of these foundations. So I'm looking through, and you know, they're mostly some kind of political entities. Washington Legal Foundation, just ridiculous stuff. So I just pulled one. Let's just take a look at one. The Foundation for Research on Economics and the Environment. The Foundation for Research on Economics and the Environment, called FREE, based in Bozeman, Montana, is a prime engine for free market environmentalism in the area of education. Now notice, education is italicized, meaning it's ridiculous. Preaching reliance on market mechanisms and private property rights rather than on environmental law for protection of the environment, its chairperson John Baden, who just happens to be a past member of the National Petroleum Council, stresses decentralization, a shift of control from what he calls green platonic despots in DC to local interests. He has written, apparently in all seriousness, that the agenda of FREE is the norm among progressive, intellectually honest, and successful environmentalists. Bullshit! One of FREE's current projects is the Charter Forest Scheme, in which the national forest would no longer operate under the multiple use mandate. Rather, each forest would be or are managed by whatever industry would be able to realize the greatest profit. For more than 10 years, FREE has been offering expense-paid seminars in its philosophy to federal judges. Seminars held primarily at resorts and private ranches in Montana with good access to trout streams and golf courses include such topics as the environment, a CEO's perspective, and liberty and the environment, a case for judicial activism. Wow. In the late 90s, FREE boasted that nearly a third of the federal judiciary had either attended or was seeking to attend its seminars. This, as the Bush administration now strives to pack federal benches with rightist judges. The group also offers expense-paid courses for university faculty and students. These reportedly taught on the campus of Montana State University. That was just one. Is that just unbelievable? All right, back to the Koch brothers. These organizations and their supporters say they are just funding their own independent studies of climate change science. Yet these studies almost go against observable scientific data to question global warming, so much so that one study funded in part by the Kochs that confirmed a rise in average world land temperature was regarded as an anomaly, which raises the question, if these studies are largely designed not to shed light on climate change, but to create doubt and confusion to delay greenhouse gas regulations, why is it legal? And do those deliberately spreading misinformation face liability? Well, I just read you. All the judges are in the pocket. The government's in the pocket. The Congress is in their pocket. They have bought everybody they need to. They can do whatever they want. Yet while people and companies enjoy the First Amendment right to free speech, legal scholars have argued that right does not extend to influencing people under false pretenses. According to former tobacco industry lawyer Steven Sussman, when it comes to fossil fuel companies and supporters funding their own research on climate change, if they knew the information they were spreading was false and being used to deliberately influence public opinion, that would override their First Amendment rights. This question may soon be playing out in the courts. Yeah, right. We'll go down here. The evidence also seems clear that comprehensive understanding of the issue for the nation was muddled, and deliberately so. In 2009, an internal global climate coalition document was leaked to the New York Times, a primer written in 1995 for the coalition members admitting that the scientific basis for the greenhouse effect and the potential impact of human emissions of greenhouse gases, such as carbon dioxide, on climate is well established and cannot be denied. Yet, we are now at the stage where denying climate change, or at least the human factor, is apparently a prerequisite for being the Republican nominee for president, as Phillips has bragged. This stance would be completely unacceptable if not for the studies funded by fossil fuel industries and supporters. And it is and has been creating disastrous U.S. policies to address the climate change. Liability? There isn't any. 2008, small Inupiat nation city of Kivalina, Alaska, filed a lawsuit against ExxonMobil and 23 other fossil fuel companies for federal public nuisance, the damage of their homeland, which will be uninhabitable within a few decades, as the sea ice is no longer sufficiently buffers the barrier reef island against erosion from false storms. Their claim argues that Kivalina has identifiable discrete harm traceable to greenhouse gas emissions, of which the defendant companies are among the world's largest contributors. They seek damages, their relocation costs. Kivalina has also charged a smaller subset of companies with secondary claims of conspiracy and concert of action for creating a false debate about climate change science In other words, these companies knew they were contributing to harm, but rather than change their practices, they instead funded a false debate about climate change science. Of course, the lawsuit was dismissed 1 year later as a political question. The district court ruled that climate change was a matter for the executive and legislative branches. The judge also denied Kivalina's legal standing to bring the suit. The secondary claims involving the misinformation campaigns of defendant companies went unaddressed. Kivalina appealed the decision with oral arguments heard in November of this year, 2011. If the claim is allowed to move forward, it could reach the discovery phase, which may unearth more documents similar to that leaked to the New York Times, suggesting deliberate intent to deceive. Of course. Defendant companies argue that climate change is not a matter for the courts. The problem is too big. We are all responsible. Yet we have not all embarked on multi-million-dollar campaigns to fund our own research and prevent any changes. It is these secondary claims that could be the crux of establishing whether fossil fuel companies will eventually bear liability for harm from greenhouse gas emissions. As prior cases involving lead, asbestos, and tobacco lawsuits show, people seem to think it is one thing to do your own research, but it is quite another to deliberately deceive people, contributing to widespread harm, primarily to retain profits. Why would these people think there was anything but that on the agenda? You know, I feel so sorry for the children, the up-and-coming children in the United States, who are, as we speak, many are in colleges and universities, and this is the kind of shit that they are taught. Lies. Absolute lies. Man. Okay, and with that, my rant is done, and thanks for watching.